Imagine you are a bird of prey and you're hunting. Now you're looking down below, but you can't really see what you're trying to hunt because it looks too small. Now, if you're a human, what you would do is you'll take out the telescope and you'll have a look and you go, ha, a thing, let's kill it. But if you're a bird of prey, you've yet to invent telescopes and therefore that's not an option for you. So what do? Normal eyeballs are balls. That's why we call them eyeballs. But if you're an owl, for example, you will have a tubular eye, which looks like that. Now, a tubular eye basically lets you have an eye that's like a telescope, which is good news for owls. However, it does mean that your eye will collapse under its own weight. One way to avoid that is by having bones in your eyes. A reminder of eye anatomy. Here is a human eye. Now, if you have a look at that, this is the white outer tough casing. It's called the sclera. Now, in birds, there is a bone that's within this sclera. It's called the sclerotic ring. It's vital for maintaining the structure of the eye because it's not ball-shaped. Now, the birds most famous for having massive sclerotic rings is the owl. The reason owls have these sclerotic rings is because they have very, very tubular eyes. However, this does mean that because of that, owls can't move their eyes, and that's why they've had to develop this very famous ability to rotate their neck at insane angles. Now, you might think, well, why is it just owls that have this? All other birds of prey also have to be able to spot prey from far distances. So why don't they have sclerotic rings in their eyes? Visual Dictionary of the Skeleton, and it looks a bit scruffy because I've had it since I was about 4 years old, but it can still be of use. If I open it to bird skeletons. Have a look at that. So we have, what do we have? A penguin, and if you have a look, it's got sclerotic rings in its eyes, and then this other example it gives, oh look, a crow. And the crow also has sclerotic rings in its eyes. It turns out pretty much all birds have sclerotic rings in their eyes. And this means that most birds can't move their eyes, just like the owl. Don't ask me why owls are known for it. It's probably because they can rotate the neck at stupid angles and other birds can't really do that. Birds are not the only animals that have had sclerotic rings throughout the ages. If you look in the fossil records, you'll find that dinosaurs had sclerotic rings. For example, this Deinonychus. You'll also find that the ichthyosaurs also had sclerotic rings in their eyes. The ichthyosaurs were, of course, marine dolphin-shaped reptiles. And the most famous example is the Ophthalmosaurus, which looked like that. Now, its name literally means eye lizard, and the reason is it has the distinction of having had the largest eye diameter with respect to the body length of any animal that's ever lived. And that's why it needed these sclerotic rings, because without them, when the animal dived, the water pressure would have collapsed its eyes easily. Now, if you look at today's animals with large eyes, the largest eye we know about belongs to the colossal squid. There are only a few specimens known because it's very rare, and the eye of the colossal squid, along with the second largest eye we know about, the giant squid, which is here, they don't have sclerotic rings. So why is that? Why don't these massive eyes, which can be the size of dinner plates, why don't they have sclerotic rings? The answer is actually pretty obvious. Squid eyes don't have any bones in them because squids don't have any bones at all. They're invertebrates. And if you look at this squid eye again, you will see that it's round and it's nice and ball shaped, and that distributes the pressure evenly and means that it's not as likely to collapse. That's big eyes for you.